Electrical wiring is certainly not the easiest task, but with the right set of tools and safety precautions, one can wire a variety of switches and outlets with the proper knowledge. Today, I want to cover an example of how to wire an outlet from a junction box. Hey, it's William here. I hope you're having a great day, and welcome back to Shop Fix, a community joined together for the love of woodworking. Let's go ahead and get this wiring started. I'm currently renovating the living room, and I need an outlet installed for a built-in desk that I'm building. First, you'll want to plan the location of the outlet box. I'm working with a one-gang new work box, which will need to be positioned between the wall studs. After making sure the outlet box was level, I traced out its position and then proceeded to cut out the drywall along the lines I just drew. After test fitting the box, it was time to bring power to the outlet. Since there was no wiring anywhere near the new outlet, I had to branch off from an existing 15 amp line via a junction box. This junction box was located in the basement just below the desk, so after marking the location of the floor stud, I was able to drill a small hole from the basement as to feed the wire up to the existing wall. Prior to drilling this hole, it's important to ensure that you can actually drill such a hole in the location you have chosen, and that no prior electrical wiring is in the way. After the hole has been drilled, you can feed your wire through. For a standard 15 amp outlet, you'll use 14 gauge wire as I am here. After feeding the wire through, you can use the hole that you previously cut out of the drywall to reach in and pull it all the way through the drywall. Be sure to leave an ample amount of wire on the outside of the wall. Although you'll only be needing 6 inches in the box, leaving extra gives you a bit of wiggle room. Now you'll want to take the rest of the wire and route it to your closest junction box. There are standard rules for holes that can be drilled in floor joists that you can look up if needed. I simply use holes that were already drilled. Another important thing to note when deciding to route wire to a junction box is deciding if that specific junction box has enough cubic inches left in the box to house a new wire. You can look this up online and determine if you have enough room, and I'll leave a link in the description below. After securing the wire to the floor joist, it's time to turn off the power to the line via your breaker box. If you do not know exactly which breaker it is wired to, simply shut off the master breaker. Open up the junction box now and feed 6 inches of wire into the box. You will need to unsheathe the portion of wire that will be housed in the junction box. I want to thank you for tuning in to this episode of Shop Fix. If you have found this video helpful, please click that like button and consider subscribing today. Let's continue by taking wire strippers to expose about a half inch of bare wire, which will be used to connect to the corresponding wires inside the junction box. Obviously, you will need to wire the junction box according to your specific situation. In my case, I simply needed to connect white to white, black to black, and ground to ground with proper wire nuts. Once the proper connections are made, push the wire back into the junction box and seal it up. Be sure to connect the ground wire to the junction box if you're using a metal style box. At this point, I can head back upstairs to finish the wiring. Make sure the power is still shut off for this line. As you can see, I'm finishing this wall with pine boards, and I needed to frame this lumber around the outlet box. Afterwards, we can unsheathe 6 inches of wire, which will be housed inside of this new work box. You can then take wire strippers to expose a little more than a half an inch of bare wire, and which will be used to loop around the terminals of the outlet. Make sure you loop the wire in the same direction as the terminal screw tightens, so that the wire doesn't get pushed out as you tighten the screw down. The white wire, if the wire is in fact neutral, should be connected to the neutral terminal on the outlet, which is oftentimes a silver or gray screw. The ground will be attached to the ground terminal, usually green, and the black wire, assuming it's hot, should be connected to the hot terminal, which is usually copper colored. After tightening the outlet to the box, you can attach your outlet cover to finish it all up.